Hi everyone, in this video we are going to discuss about Simethicone. What is this drug Simethicone? Simethicone is one of the anti-flatulent agent. So this drug is going to reduce the flatulence, the expulsion of gases through the rectum, which is developed because of any indigestion, dyspepsia or any other gastrointestinal disorders, or due to the diet, use of any drugs which increase the gas formation. All these conditions can produce the flatulence, which is reduced by Simethicone. This Simethicone acts as surfactant, so it reduces the surface tension. That's why Simethicone acts as anti-foaming agent. Since foam entraps the gas, when this foam is reduced, the gas entrapment is also reduced. In this way, Simethicone acts as anti-flatulent agent. And if we see the prefix and suffix of this drug, we can easily observe that Simethicone is a silicone derivative. And here the infix myth indicates it is having a methyl group. So it's a dimethyl polysiloxane derivative. In many of the preparations, Simethicone acts as anti-flatulent agent. But this Simethicone can also be used as contrast agent. When it is coated on cellulose, it can be used for sonographic examination of upper abdomen. So, in the ultrasound examination, Simethicone can be used as contrast agent. But medicinally, this drug is mainly used as anti-flatulent agent. On the digestive system, diet plays an important effect. So, what are the dietary components consumed? They can produce some chemical reactions within the stomach, which can promote the formation of gas, and this gas is present as gas bubbles. So large bubbles are going to be produced which are entrapping the gas, particularly few of the gases such as nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide are going to be produced within the stomach and intestine. And what are the gas entrapped in these large bubbles can produce some abdominal pain, bloating, the fullness of the stomach, belching, expulsion of the gases through the mouth, and flatulence, which again produce some rectal gas, and indigestion. All these symptoms are observed with increased gas formation within the stomach. Now here Simethicone acts as surfactant. These Simethicone molecules can coat on these gas bubbles so that they can reduce the surface tension. Thereby they can reduce the size of the bubbles, and they can also act as anti-foaming agent so that they can dissolve these gas bubbles to release the gas. In this way, Simethicone reduces the gas entrapment within the stomach and colon. Now, this Simethicone can be given alone, otherwise it can be given in combination. Generally, this drug is combined with few of the antacids such as aluminium hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide. So, we have few of the suspensions which are having these three components. Otherwise, it can be combined with few of the drugs such as levosulpiride, which is an antipsychotic agent that can be used in the treatment of irritable bowel syndrome or GERD, gastroesophageal reflux disorder. In these conditions, Simethicone can be combined with levosulpiride. Now, let us the chemical nature of this drug. All we have seen that Simethicone is a polymer. So, this is the structure of Simethicone, where we can observe methyl substituted siloxane moieties. So, it is a simply polydimethyl siloxane derivative which is combined with silicon dioxide. So, this mixture is nothing but Simethicone. And generally, these type of polysiloxanes are having some resinous structure and they can adsorb as well as they can act as anti-foaming agents. Now, let us see how this drug acts. Within the colon, the dietary components can produce some chemical reactions which produce the gas formation such as nitrogen, carbon dioxide, oxygen. So, these gaseous molecules, when they are entrapped along with the fluid, they can produce few of the gas bubbles. Generally, these gas bubbles are destroyed and gas is released. But in the patients with any dyspepsia, severe flatulence or any gastrointestinal disorders, large bubbles are going to be formed. As the number of gas bubbles are more formed, the pressure within the colon is going to be increased. So, these bubbles can affect the colon so that they can increase the pressure within the colon. And these bubbles, when they are passing through a narrow section of colon, they can produce some block, and this block results in some pain as well as bloating within the patients. Now, Simethicone is one of the surfactant which can act on these bubbles to reduce the pressure as well as pain. Being a surfactant, it can reduce the surface tension, thereby can dissolve these gas bubbles which release the pressure as well as pain within the colon. In this way, Simethicone acts as anti-flatulent agent, as well as it reduces the bloating as well as pain within the patients. Now let us see the side effects of Simethicone. Since this drug acts on gastrointestinal system, it can produce few of the side effects related with the GIT. It can produce some diarrhea, some headache, nausea, and vomiting can be observed with this Simethicone. This drug is not significantly absorbed, so it only shows local side effects on gastrointestinal system. How it is given? This drug is available as tablets as well as capsules, and is also available as oral suspension. The adult dose of the drug is variable from 40 to 125 mg given 4 times daily. But in the children, the dose is 40 mg given 4 times daily. So this drug should be given in the children above 2 years only. Below 2 years, it is not suitable. So for relieving any colic pain, this Simethicone should not be used in infants. So that's about this drug Simethicone, which is an anti-flatulent agent which can relieve the pressure created by the gas that is formed within the stomach and colon. This drug mainly reduces the surface tension, thereby can reduce the bubble size, as well as it can act as an anti-foaming agent so that it can prevent the formation of foam. By all of these actions, it can dissolve the gas bubbles so that the gas is going to be released without any entrapment. But this drug produces some diarrhea, headache, nausea, and vomiting as few of the important side effects. This drug can be combined with antacids, otherwise it can be combined with antipsychotics like levosulpiride. It is given at a dose of 40 to 125 mg, given 4 times daily. But in the children with age 2 to 12 years, it is given at a dose of 40 mg, given 4 times daily. So that's about this drug Simethicone. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.